नमस्कार। सो इन दिस वीडियो वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस आइडेंटिटी थ्योरम वर्जन 2। ओके, फर्स्ट वर्जन हैज ऑलरेडी डिस्कस्ड इन द कॉन्सेप्ट ऑफ द डे एंड टू नाइट। यस, दिस इज नॉट द कॉन्सेप्ट ऑफ द डे, दिस इज कॉन्सेप्ट ऑफ द नाइट बिकॉज आई एम लेट टूडे बट विल नॉट बी फ्रॉम टुमोरो। ऑल राइट, सो फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल आई वुड लाइक टू डिस्कस व्हाट इज आइडेंटिटी थ्योरम वर्जन 2। Okay, and we'll apply that on this question. Yes, that has been asked in CSIR 2012 and it was of 4.75 marks. Okay, so you people will say that, oh, before coming to this question, why are you not saying the identity theorem version 2? So let's go to say it and thereafter we will apply it on this CSIR net question. Identity theorem form 2 or version 2, you can say. What is this? Think, you are given a domain D. Certainly it is connected. All right. And you have two functions F and G. And these two functions are what? Analytic in D. These two functions are analytic in D. All right, these two functions are analytic in D. This is the given thing. Okay, what is the given thing? F and G are two functions analytic on a domain D. Certainly the D is what? A connected domain. Right, then if your F and G are ready to agree on a set A. What do you mean by this? I mean to say, if your F and G are equal to each other for all the points in a set A, all right, and if A has a limit point in D, A has a limit point on D, what does it mean? It means in the derived set of A, if you will take its intersection with D, then you are not going to get phi. So A dash intersection D is not equals to phi. If A has a limit point in D, then certainly you will say what? Then what would you like to say? Your F and G are identically equal in D. What does it mean? It means your F of Z and your G of Z will be equals to each other for all Z belongs to the domain. For all Z belongs to the domain, these two will be equals to each other. Okay, so in the version 2, two functions are analytic on a domain D. Domain is connected. If your F and G are equal on a particular set A, which has a limit point in the domain, okay, then A dash, limit point in a domain means what? Derived set is the collection of all the limit points of A. So A dash intersection D is not equals to phi. Then your F will be identically equals to G. I mean to say there will be no difference between F and G in your domain. They will be identical. This is what identity theorem version 2. And now we are going to apply it right here. Okay, so first of all, what the thing is given? F from C to C. Okay, F from C to C be a meromorphic function. Meromorphic function means what? The only singularity of F will be what? A kind of pool. There will not be any essential singularity. Okay, this is what the meaning of meromorphic. And it is also given F is analytic at zero. Satisfying this condition, F of 1 by n is equals to n upon 2n plus 1. Okay, for n greater than or equal to 1. Okay, so these are the given things. So your function is analytic at 0. So what would you like to say? F is analytic at 0. What does it mean? There exists a neighborhood of 0. There exists a neighborhood of 0 such that F is analytic. Isn't it? Analyticity means what? At that particular point, certainly the function will be differentiable, and in the neighborhood of that also your point, all the regular points will be there. So you can say in a particular domain D, let's say your f will be what? Analytic. And now you will say, where is the g in this question? You may ask, where is the g in this question? You have defined that g in this identity theorem. So don't worry, I will let you to see. Okay, so first of all, what is your f of 1 by n? Okay, you have to make a function. So what is your f of 1 by n? Your f of 1 by n will be what? Here is n, and upon 2n plus 1 is the thing right there. So if you will take n as common, so it will become n into 1 upon n into 2 plus 1 by n, right? So this n to n will be cancelled and you will get 1 by 2 plus 1 by n. Okay, so what is the thing right there? F of 1 by n is equals to 1 by 2 plus 1 by n. Okay, do you know, according to the theorem, I would like to tell you that this is our g. Okay, because if you will put, because this here is a equality, so whatever 1 by n you are going to put over here, the same thing should be put over here, and these two will be what? Equal. So now if you are saying your f is analytic in a domain D in the neighborhood of 0, okay, so let's take that as the domain, then you can see what? Your f and g both are analytic, isn't it? Both are analytic in the domain D. And if you will try to write a set A, which is what? Actually the set of all the zeros of f and g. I mean to say, set is what? 1 by n, and certainly your n greater than or equal to 1. So this is the set on which f is equals to g, isn't it? F is equals to g. And you people know that where its limit point will go, its limit point will go to 0. And the domain of f, where the function were analytic, where what? The neighborhood of 0. So certainly your domain contains 0, and the limit point of A is the set where f and g are going to agree, where f and g are equal to each other, okay, on A. And the limit point of A and your domain D are going to intersect with each other. Their intersection is not equals to phi. What does it imply? It implies that your f and g are equal or identically equal to each other on D. So now you are able to take your function f as how? How will you write your f of z? If you will write z is equals to 1 by n, for instance, then certainly you can define your function f of z as 1 by 2 plus z. Isn't it? You can write that as 1 by 2 plus z. Okay. Yes. And if you will take z is equals to 0, then you are going to get what? At z is equals to 0, it will become half. So option A is right. Okay, option A is right. What is your function? Your function is f of z is equals to z plus 2, isn't it? So you can see z is equals to minus 2 will be what? A pole. And certainly it's simple because its order is 1. So certainly that will be a pole. So this is also right. And f of 2 is equals to 1 by 4 is given. F of 2 is equals to 1 by 4. So if you will put f of 2, z is equals to 2, then you are going to get 1 by 2 plus 2, which is what? 1 by 4. So option C is also right. Okay. So all the three options are right. So final answer will be what? A, B, and C. So A, B, and C will be what? Your right answer. Okay, so I hope you understand. Okay, everything is clear for this identity theorem 2. If any doubt will be there, then you are welcome in the comment section. Thank you very much, everyone. Please check the playlist once, and certainly you can check the schedule in our community. All right, and certainly a continuous lecture will come for sure. Thank you very much.